Hello, welcome to the Bakwas channel for self-paced tutorials on Raspberry Pi Pico. This video will demonstrate the steps to set up the ArduCAM RP2040 board for the development of TinyML exercises. There are two key objectives for this demonstration. First, use a setup script to install the libraries and utilities on the host desktop or notebook client to develop code that can be run on the ArduCAM RP2040 board. Second, check that the recommended IDE, namely VS Code, has been installed through the setup script. The microcontroller unit, or MCU, is based on ARM Cortex M0 Plus core. The MCU is named RP2040. The chip has been licensed by Raspberry Pi Foundation to third-party manufacturers who have not lost time and ground in introducing their custom solutions. ArduCAM has provided camera solutions for single-board computers for over a decade. It has considerable experience with low-pixel, low-cost cameras for a variety of solutions, including those that require pan, tilt, and zoom features, commonly referred to as PTZ. This series of self-paced tutorials will step through the pre-trained models to help you become familiar with deploying TinyML models on Pico boards. There will be separate presentations on training the models, since these steps would be external to the Pico boards. Since this tutorial is limited to illustrating the setup steps for the ArduCAM RP2040 board, any coding activity is not in scope. The preferred integrated development environment, or IDE, is Microsoft VS Code, which is different from Microsoft Visual Studio. VS Code is free, open source software from talented folks at Microsoft. It is portable across many platforms. Visual Studio, on the other hand, is a subscription service with several tiers. Simple demonstrations of VS Code for Pico applications will be covered in future tutorials. Similarly, simple TinyML model training and testing exercises will be demonstrated in a series of future tutorials. Needless to add, that there is no way that a single short presentation can even pretend to convey the basic principles of machine learning. We will try to cover the key topics on machine learning using TinyML in a future series of tutorials. The ArduCAM RP2040 Pico ML board shares the same form factor and pin layout as the original Raspberry Pi Pico board. There is sufficient space on the board to accommodate the following extra components on one side: a low pixel camera, a 9 degrees of freedom inertial management unit, and a microphone. On the other side, there is a monochrome display. Note that for image recognition purposes, especially in the current learning environment, monochrome or grayscale is perfectly adequate. The Raspberry Pi Foundation supplies the RP2040 chips in the traditional reels to licensees. The key characteristics of the chips are dual-core ARM Cortex M0 Plus processor at 133 MHz, 264 kilobytes of static random access memory, volatile memory when data is lost, when power is removed. 2 megabytes quad serial peripheral interface for flash memory. 26 general purpose input-output pins, of which 3 are available for analog use. 2 universal asynchronous receiver transmitters. 2 serial peripheral interface. 2 inter-integrated circuit, which is the Philips NXP invention. 16 pulse width modulation. 8 processor input-output. There's an on-chip clock, a temperature sensor, and accelerated integer and floating point libraries on the chip. The operating power range is from 1.8 to 5.5 volts DC. The QVGA mono camera, although available separately for use in generic Pico boards, is mounted on the ArduCAM RP2040 board at the factory. This approach is excellent for training or teaching purposes, since no fiddling with wires is needed to ensure correct pin connectivity. The 3 other cameras for a generic Pico board are VGA, 2 megapixel, and 5 megapixel color. The key specifications of the onboard camera are 320 by 320 monochrome at 60 frames per second max, configurable 1-bit video data serial interface with video frame and line sync, ultra low power consumption, standby is 200 microwatts, and at operating QQVGA is less than 1.1 milliwatt. Motion detection wake up interrupt output is available, and it's designed for always on service application. The inertial measurement unit is based on the ICM chip 2948. There are 9 degrees of freedom, 3 axes for the gyroscope, 3 for the accelerometer, and 3 for the compass. There is a digital motion processor and a digital output temperature sensor. The microphone uses pulse code modulation directly, uses 20-bit 16 kHz sample rate, mono channel, and 64 decibel signal to noise ratio. The display uses the ST7735 chip. It has a low 160 by 80 pixel resolution, relies on a serial peripheral interface, and the dimension is to 0.96 inches liquid crystal display. The setup tasks are listed below. These tasks require approximately 40 minutes on a Raspberry Pi 3B model computer. The best part, as shown on the following slides, is that a single command will take care of running all these tasks sequentially without further manual intervention. Of course, it is always prudent to run update upgrade before running these commands. It is highly recommended that the repository be cloned from GitHub as shown in the second line of the commands below. Then run the setup script. It will take approximately 40 minutes. At the conclusion of the setup script, a reboot is necessary to make the installed libraries and utilities available for development use. After the reboot is complete, perform a simple validation of the setup installation. Launch VS Code from a command line. The command to launch VS Code is simply code space dot. Once VS Code is up and running, check its version number to ensure that it is indeed the supported version for Raspberry Pi platforms. That's all, folks. Thanks for patiently viewing this video. Leave any comments, as you wish, in the section below. Remember, criticisms are welcome too. Until the next presentation soon, bye for now.